Hey guys, T-Glizzy here, and I'm excited to be bringing you guys another awesome video. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to obtain the mountaintop and the easiest method on obtaining this weapon. So it's a very cutthroat quest, it's super easy to get done, and I'm just going to go ahead and explain to you guys all the tips that I can offer and all the best facts that I can offer, and make sure you guys can obtain this gun within one reset. So one reset is all you're going to need to dedicate to this gun, and you will be able to have it. Might take you 5 days, might take you 3, just depending on your play style, but you will definitely get this gun by playing like this. So let's dive right into it. And so what I mean by playing like this is your play style is going to have to completely change for this quest line. You're going to be having to play as a completely new player and throw away any tactics that you use now and basically string in these brand new ones. So the first thing you're going to need is a hunter, and you're going to be wanting to run the top tree void walker. Next, you're going to need at least 2 grenade launchers. You're going to need either the Militia Birthright, the Orange Maw, or the Fighting Lion. The Fighting Lion is the easiest one to obtain, so I do recommend just grabbing the Fighting Lion and using that and then pairing it up with any legendary grenade launcher. But if you do have your own legendary special grenade launcher, then go ahead and equip that and also pair it up with an exotic heavy weapon. So you can go ahead and either put on the Colony or the Prospector, and the Colony is definitely probably the easiest one to use. All you got to do is shoot a couple mites at the floor and they'll track down the enemy for you, and it is the best one to use for grabbing those multi-kills. But if you guys are just struggling with the quest and you already know what guns to use and all that other good shazam, I want to just say that the exotic that I don't see a lot of people using and is the key to getting this gun is the Graviton Lance. So this is the exotic helmet for the hunter, which extends your invisibility duration for like an extra 3 or 4 seconds. It's kind of crazy, but it makes you invisible for a little bit longer. This is going to come into benefit because you're going to be queuing up for the Mayhem playlist. You're going to be waiting for Mayhem to come around and be playing the Mayhem playlist. You cannot get this inside of quick play. Even though it's possible, it will take a very long time. You want Mayhem to come around because this is where you're going to be able to regenerate your supers a lot. You're going to be able to use all of your abilities a lot, and you're going to be needing all of this to actually complete this quest, because you're going to be needing double kills and multi kills to actually progress this quest quite fast. So basically what I'm trying to say is you're going to be needing Mayhem, the Graviton Lance, and also bringing in 2 grenade launchers with you into the Crucible to complete this. So now that your build is complete, now it's time to take an in-depth look at the playstyle. So your playstyle is going to have to change for this gun. You're going to be playing a completely different playstyle that you probably won't play again after you get this gun. It is a very slow playstyle, and you are going to be playing very passive. So once you get into a room, you're going to want to go ahead and use your super. So you're going to want to make sure you have your super for each gunfight, and you're going to want to find the room with the most traffic. Once you're in a room, you're going to want to go ahead and pop your super either on the ceiling or, you know, above a doorway. Never put it on the floor, because the floor is just too easy for people to shoot at it and to actually see where the actual tether is. So once you place your super down, then you want to play like a spider. You want to go ahead and use your cloak, and once you're in cloak, like I said, you're going to be able to be invisible for very long, and with it being Mayhem, you can be invisible for essentially forever. Once you click invisibility, it'll be able to be recharged again, and you can go ahead and go cloak again. So you'll be invisible forever while your tether's on the wall, and people will be gathering towards your tether because it does bloop on the map. It shows up as a red enemy, so people are just rushing into the room to go ahead and super you, and you are invisible the whole time. As soon as they enter the room, next thing you know, they're tethered, and all you have to do is kill them with your grenade launcher. So by the gameplay in the background, that was my exact playstyle, and I went ahead and did this for about 10 hours, and I was able to get about 70% of the quest done. So it was really, really easy, guys. Flew right by. All you have to do is basically play really, really slow, and make sure you go into each of your encounters and you know what you're going into. Make sure you go into each encounter with your super, and make sure you go into each encounter with your grenade launcher ready and loaded. But yeah, that is the best tips that I can give to you guys about getting the mountaintop. I'm also going to be hosting some of my own servers and stuff like that, where I am going to be helping some of you guys grab the mountaintop and going in there using my own tethers and just tethering people for you guys and letting you guys get grenade launcher kills. I feel like that's the best way I can help out without actually cheesing and setting up some type of cheesy method so we all could get it right. So I want to make something like that for you guys soon. But if you guys liked this video, please be sure to let me know by slamming that thumbs up button, and don't forget to subscribe. And as always, I've been T-Glizzy. You guys have been my awesome viewers, and I'll see you guys in another. Peace.